everybody. It's your favorite host, Jennifer and Donnie from Brew Review University. And here we are at it again at Fullwave Studios grand opening. And we have another guest with us. This is Callie Paige. So welcome her here. And we're just going to jump right into the questions.
We know you're Callie Paige. Right? How do you know Richard?
I know Richard because I took a program called Six Figure Songwriting with Kathy Hiller. And then Sam Knock, I always want to say Knack, I think a lot of people do, and I've heard him correct a few people, so he was one of the mentors. He wasn't my particular mentor in the group, but he kind of branched off and started his own mixing group, and Richard is also in that group, and so Richard and I got to know each other more in that setting, and okay. We started talking about maybe collaborating together, and we have done a song together. It's not out or finished yet, but it will be, and I'm looking forward to that. And I've been watching his whole, like, from the beginning to now.
Yes.
And it feels magical. I feel I feel very happy
yes.
for him.
Yes.
I heard part of your set out there. What style would you say you are?
I actually am still discovering that. Because
yes.
when I started, they're like, you gotta pick a lane. And I'm like, all right, am I supposed to know which lane I want to pick? And so I realized, all right, we'll just try things out. And I'm sure that I'll land on something. And so far, it's mostly some category of pop. It's a lot of different types of pop. Some contemporary jazz, some blues, some folk. I like to do some cinematic stuff as well. I'm willing to try anything at this point, but I haven't landed on, like, and I've done a lot of EDM with different people. It's just fun. I feel like I enjoy being outside the box a little
yes.
bit. So.
Yes. Yes.
You don't need to stay in the box. You know, don't listen to them.
Yeah.
Be your own person.
Trust me, yes.
Someone doesn't stay in the box.
It's more fun that way.
It is.
Your question next.
My question is, do you have a musical influence?
That's really hard for me. I am bad with names and faces. I don't know what it is about me, but I don't forget something I've heard before, mm-hmm. interestingly enough. When I was younger, I listened to... We didn't have a lot of CDs. You know, every now and then we got to go buy a CD from the store. I think I had a Celine Dion CD, Mariah Carey, when I was in Spain, there was, like, Spice Girls was big, and Michael Jackson, and, like, MC
yes.
Hammer. when those songs came on, everybody got out of the pool, or, like, whatever they were doing, everybody was, like, doing something because of that song. And my sister had, like, she was more into, like, alternative rock, and she had, like, Korn and Limp Bizkit and things like that.
Oh,
on
those are my bands.
Pumpkins. And
yes.
so, like, when she was gone, I would, like, steal her CDs and listen to that, you know, a little CD player, and...
Yeah,
you know, certain things like that, but that was when I was younger, and yeah, those things, and I guess those were like my childhood influences that I listened to often.
Yeah.
Nothing
wrong with childhood influences. they stick around with you no matter what.
Yeah.
So.
Other than your vocal instrument, do you play any other instruments?
I did play guitar and piano by ear. I did have some issues with my hands. I had surgery on both hands, so I don't play as much anymore. I'm going to try to get back to it. But a mental setback when you realize you can't play as well as you once did, it makes you feel a certain way. So I'm going to try to get over that. But I never learned to read music. But we were given a piano when I was like 11 from my grandparents. And I just started playing that. So I play a little by ear. And hand drums, I like to play. I don't consider myself a player of those things, though. It's just, if it's around, I like to have
yes.
fun on it.
Yes, exactly.
When was your first performance, and for how many people?
I think, like, open mic a couple months ago.
Wow.
Okay.
Just a couple handfuls of people. The Music Box in San Diego, it popped up one day, and I was like, I'm gonna do it. I've actually had, like, crippling stage fright, so,
that was my next question. Stage fright. Yeah, stage fright. So, obviously, we still get stage fright a little bit.
Yeah. My mind goes a little blank. I don't know. I can't even explain what it is. I just feel overwhelmed, and when I kind of check out when I feel overwhelmed. So, it's like, what am I singing and what are my lyrics? And so it feels, you know, a little overwhelming.
It happens to us too. Oh, yeah. I'll be sitting here asking questions and just blank out. Just won't remember what my next question was. So,
yeah.
Anyway, just like now.
Here we go.
Yes.
Again. I have a quick question. Your first concert you attended?
Well, when I lived in Spain, there was like ballets, and I remember like live music a lot there. So I don't really know. I was a kid, so I don't really like know who I was seeing. But there was a lot of influence going on. I guess Spanish influence, local people, and music from the ballets. I remember a lot of classical music from like my young childhood, like 5 and younger, and maybe up to 8. But then. I'm sorry, what was the question again?
Concert.
So came to America, and my elementary school best friend, her name's Serenity, and her mom, she was obsessed with NSYNC and the Backstreet Boys. And her mom bought tickets, and they took me with them to the NSYNC concert. And actually, they weren't big at the time, but oh my gosh, I can't even remember the name of them, but they're big now. They're like one of the bigger bands, a male singer. I think he was one of the judges on one of those singing shows, like the one where the chair turns around.
Oh,
Adam
Levine.
Adam Levine.
Yes. So whatever band he was in at the time, he was like the side stage person, I believe, if I'm not mistaken. But
I wouldn't know.
If I'm not mistaken, I believe that's what it was. And it was I love that. Yeah.
Yeah. Cool.
I have 4 quick questions for you. Dog or cat?
Dog or cat?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, if I'm a dog or cat person or if I have one?
If you're a dog or cat person.
I love them both.
See?
When I was younger, I had like 15 pets at one time.
Oh.
Yeah. We had lots of pets.
I love them both too. We have them both, so.
I have a dog now, but my oldest daughter is allergic to cats, and so I can't have a cat.
Oh.
And she wants a cat.
Yeah.
Pizza or hamburger?
Hamburger, because I can't have cheese.
Oh.
But I do love pizza. I miss pizza so very much.
Beach or mountains?
Ooh, that's hard. You know what? I'm gonna have to go with mountains. I had a weird beach experience one time. And I love to go look at the beach, but I actually don't go on the sand much.
Okay.
Yeah.
This one will go to the beach, but he won't go in the water.
Yeah, yes. You know, I lived in Spain where the water was clear, and when I came to the U.S., it, like, freaked me out. Like, I couldn't see what was in the water, and I didn't go into the beach for a very long time.
And one last question for you. Stay in or go out?
It depends on my mood. Sometimes I want to go anywhere. You couldn't pay me to go, but... Yeah. Sometimes I can't stay inside. I could just have to go somewhere. So it just depends.
I see. That's all the questions I have for you.
That's all we have. We're so glad you joined us. We're just going to finish up with some business. But we hope you guys enjoyed the show. And we all love the support. So give us some love. Give her some love. And that's all we got
like
for
today. Like we do. Sir.
Thank you so much for being on the
Thank
show.
Thank you very much.
Cheers.
Thank you. Cheers.
Cheers.